I'm Morgan Holzer. I'm co-chair of Spectrum, which is a group at the Metropolitan Museum that puts on events like this. I'm thrilled tonight to have the all-stars of the Upright Citizens Brigade Theater joining us. Give them a round of applause. In honor of the special exhibition, our Drawings and Prints exhibition, Infinite Jest, which is a history of caricature and satire. It is open on the second floor, just at the top of the stairs in the Great Hall. Open through March 4th, and will be open after tonight's performance. You can go up and see it. If everyone could turn their cell phones off, that would be great, and that would be the cue to bring everybody out. Thank you.
How many people of you just came here because it was raining outside? You didn't we're going to do some improv for you guys tonight. For any of you who haven't seen improv before, it's all made up on the spot, never been done before, never will be done again.
For better or for worse.
For better or for worse. We're going to bring somebody up on stage, and we're going to interview them, and we're going to do a show based off of that interview. So is there...
For our interview, we don't need you to be funny at all. We're not going to make fun of you. We just want you to be honest and talk to us just about your life, who you are, what you do, the basic stuff. Nothing too crazy.
All you have to be is forthcoming and honest.
That's right. You don't have to be funny at all. And we will not attack you, we promise. Does anybody want to volunteer? All right, Valerie, thank you very much for volunteering. So, Valerie, what brings you to the show tonight?
I love improv.
Oh, okay.
I love it. I do it on the side.
It's my favorite thing. What is your major? What do you do for a living?
I'm a managing editor at a pharma medical ad agency.
What I do on the side. Oh, am I getting it?
Yeah.
So you're an editor at a pharma. So explain to me what that is. It just trade papers or is it?
It's drugs.
Well, I know pharma. Yeah. But what is the product?
What is the magazine? Oh, it's different things. It's conferences for doctors. It's ads that you'd see in magazines for the drugs that say, you know, don't do this, don't do that. It's digital websites, tablets,
so
iPads.
Walk me through your day. You wake up, you show up at the office. What are you editing? What are you working? Like, what did you work on today?
Today, I worked on an arrhythmia drug for the heart, and I worked on.
But when you say worked on it, you are
editing it.
You're editing descriptions.
Grammar, punctuation, style, content.
But not the drug itself. There is something
Unfortunately, correct.
And then you're making sure that what everything's putting, you're fact checking?
I'm going to hire you. Fact checking it, making sure your things are correct. I know. I'm so impressed. You're hired. Yeah. It's fact-checking it, it's making sure that the last round, the changes were implemented from the writer, the client.
What are some common mistakes that people make in writing copy for ads about pharmaceuticals?
It's the cure-all for everything.
That's pretty lazy copy editing, yeah. Right? It's like, I'm a copywriter for drugs and people just go, it's great, it does everything.
Exactly, right.
Yeah. I gotta make my dinner.
And common mistakes are just misspellings.
Sure.
Not having backup to support the claims.
How does it get that far to you? Like, how is it that they, who's writing, the copy editors are writing things that they really are, you get ads and things that are going to go out to actual publications where people are making absurd claims for the...
Well, that's where we come in, because we're the editorial department.
So who's trying to push this stuff?
The clients, you know, the big drug companies, you know, like...
Name names.
P&G.
Yeah. I see a sniper up there.
Yeah. And we do a lot of defies or thank you. We have you hired also.
Is it fairing?
You're fired.
They might have been bought out.
You're not fired. Wow.
That's okay.
So how long, is that a fun job? Like, do you like the people you work with?
I do.
You keep looking over there. Is there someone that works with you?
Someone worked postal on me today. The other day. And was cursing at me.
Tell me a story. Why was he cursing? Why was she cursing?
It was the first, I'm on this new account, and it was the first time I ever worked with her. And, you know, she had been out of town, and editorial had, you know, mixed up something that she wanted done, and but it was understood why we did this incorrectly, and she was screaming at me and cursing
at
me.
What was she saying? Tell me the specifics.
I'm not giving it back to editorial so it can go into a black hole, you know, and you'll be in there for 6 days. I said, we got this project on Thursday and gave it
and
back to
you. And what is the project? Is it an ad or what is
no,
it?
It's a slide deck.
So it's a bunch of slides.
It's a bunch of slides.
And she came into your office just...
No. In the hallway in front of everybody. Okay. Which was even nicer.
And it slides about what?
About the arrhythmia drug.
About an arrhythmia drug.
Yeah. And she... yes, it's a heart.
Arrhythmia.
Yeah, she gave me a heart condition. Arrhythmia, right. I just started, so I'm looking out. So she was like, I go, we just got it. And she was like, you know, it was ready on Tuesday. And I said, we got it Thursday, gave it back to you Friday.
Is it a lot of, pressure cooker stuff, this industry? Is it a lot of people flipping out, flipping their shit constantly over pharmaceutical
This was the first
slides?
Time, yeah, this is the first time. And then she was like, I go, well, you know, as nice as pie, even though internally I was freaking out.
Okay.
And I said, excuse me. I said to her, you know, we'd be happy to take it back. You know, you don't match the anger. You know, you just be nice back.
Sure.
If you get spit on, right. You don't, like a dog. If you don't, you know, you don't lose your cool. And that's part of my job.
Yeah.
Don't lose your cool. And I said, we'd be happy to get it back, you know, to you. And she's like, I'm doing it myself! You know, and I was like,
wow.
You know, so she was reprimanded and apologized.
Gotcha.
But
so where do you, besides improv, what and your work, what do you do for fun? What do you like to do?
Improv.
Besides improv.
Yeah. Besides improv,
into a black hole of our own.
I do want to give a plug. My cousin is nominated for an Oscar.
Oh.
He wrote the screenplay, David F. Shamoon wrote the screenplay for In Darkness.
Uh-huh.
Which is nominated for Best Foreign Film.
Okay.
No one here can help him.
And it would
be if you know anyone,
it's too late, right?
Pointing at the count
on you. They won't even let me watch some of the movies. I have no say in the matter. I just dress up like fat ladies on TV.
I'll get him to write.
So,
I'm a bike rider.
You're a bike rider?
You live
in the city? Or?
Yes, I live in the city. I'm going to be in the 5-borough bike tour.
Oh, cool.
May 6th, 42 miles.
No more plugs.
No more plugs. Okay. I love Upright Citizens Brigade. It's a great place.
Tell me, how'd you get into biking? Have you always been into that, or is that something
I loved doing. I feel like it's the Valerie show. I hope you guys know.
It is the Valerie.
Oh, it is, yeah. Thank you.
I had done theater over the summer in Kentucky, and all the Manhattanites don't have cars, and I was sick of not seeing beautiful places when I did summer theater. So I went into a bike store and I said, can I borrow a bike for a month? And they're like, actually no, but you can buy one. And I said, okay, I'll buy one. And this was before it cost $8,000 for luggage. They broke it down. It was before they started charging for luggage.
Right.
And so I biked all around Kentucky, and I was like the person that got stuff for the Manhattanites. Like, I'd go to the drugstore and get stuff for people. I was kind of the messenger.
Yeah.
And then when I got back to the city, I fell in love with it even more. And I got more committed to biking because my leg went into the subway, into the gap.
What?
Yeah.
In between the trains?
Yeah, in between the trains.
You were switching cars?
No, I was walking on the 2 and the 3, and my entire leg up to here went into the gap right before the train was pulling out. And
I slipped.
And yeah. The gap was just, they're the new trains, and they say they fit. They don't fit. There's a big gap, and my whole leg went in it. And everyone started screaming. They're like, stop the train, stop the train. And I was like, they pulled me up, and I was like, do I have a leg? And just kidding. Sorry if anyone has a bad leg. But so the thing that
six
happened,
people are leaving. Slowly.
I know. What happened? Why I committed is when I went to the ER, the doctor said because my legs were so strong, they said.
Damn, girl.
And one thing I'm proud of, my legs. From anything up from there, it needs work, but the legs are good. But it made me realize because my legs are so strong that it could have been another way. It's just like I had bruises everywhere, not a break, nothing.
So you slipped and you were falling in.
I was stuck.
How many seconds are now? Are you like this?
Exactly like that.
Exactly like that.
And the people are like this.
Yeah. I lost a shoe. No, I did lose a shoe, but that was a joke.
So because you had a strong leg, you
were able
to pull it up.
No,
you just didn't get
able to flex your muscle and send the
move the train over to that express track.
I'm like a starfish, it grew back.
There's a subway, if you see it, with just like a tiny mark like this on the side of it.
Exactly.
Yeah. Wow, that's
cool.
Do you remember where you were going that day?
To work.
You were going
I
to
didn't
work?
Go that day.
Did they buy? They bought these.
Well, it was funny because when I was a kid, my dad was always the strong one. So if we had a fender bender, you know, or anything, we'd be like, "Is dad there?" You know, and my mom would go, "What happened? What happened?" Well, this time I called my parents from the ER and I went, "Is dad there?" And my mom goes, "What happened?" She knew something was wrong.
Yeah.
But I was on my way to work, and I said to them, I prefaced it, and I said, boy, you're not going to believe this one, why I'm not going to be at work. And they were wonderful, and they actually brought work to me.
That's wonderful.
So I laid up on the couch with, giant ice bags. That was great for a party. Because of biking.
Wow, that's amazing.
I'm not kidding you.
Was the train moving at all?
It was about to. It was like the doors were about to close, and it was about to pull out, and they were all screaming. I was.
You hear that? I'm not going to bitch about crowded subways ever again. It could be way worse.
And this one lady and I. It was during the summer, so I had flats on, and they fell off. And this lady's like giving me socks from her gym bag because I had a naked foot on a beautiful clean subway. It was 96th Street.
You want to go lay flowers?
He's gonna go. I'm gonna go get that shoe. I'm gonna go.
Seriously, but people were so wonderful, and it was interesting because it was on September 12th of about 4 years ago. So I think people are always a little bit nicer around that time, and people, and I think everyone who says New Yorkers don't care. Yeah. I'm proud to be a New Yorker, even though I grew up in the South.
Yeah.
But,
Virginia.
Yeah.
What was that like? Rural or?
It was Virginia Beach, and it was a lot of fun. It was a great place to grow up. Cool. You know, it was interesting because I was in the Bible Belt, and I was the first Jewish person a lot of people met, so I hope I was a good ambassador, because a lot of people...
Were people that unfamiliar with Jewish culture? Really?
Yeah.
And how do you think you were an ambassador?
Because I hope that I'm a nice person, and they because people have stereotypes, and they were like, you have horns in your head, and all that. So
really?
Oh yeah.
I mean, I don't want to rattle off all the stereotypes I know, but that is not one of them. Yeah. I mean, I've heard that one, but in like a joke sense.
You mean about which
about
stories?
Oh, yeah. That's medieval, though.
I know.
That's totally medieval.
I wasn't sure about it. And they're like, what's Yom Kippur? You know, and
well, that's
stuff
a
like
legit
that.
Question.
Like, that's a question.
That's
a question. If you're not Jewish, is it legit? What's this holiday?
Yeah.
That's not on the same place. Like, show me your horn.
I'm like, I was like, that was a song. Can we have Kippur for breakfast? Mommy, do you want me? Anyway, I'm but it was interesting, and people were like, oh, you're gonna go to hell, and you know, it was
people just casually rattle that off to
yes,
you.
And I said, I hope so. Yeah, I said, I'm proud. But the horn head was a little kooky, and then the other thing that bothered me, and you have to correct people too, like a lot of my friends started saying, oh man, I got so chewed, you know, and I was like,
that's wrong. Just kidding.
Actually, it's a very good expression. I use it all the time. You know, but yeah, stuff like that where I had to say, that's offensive, you know?
Yeah.
And it's, you know, but I loved growing up there,
yeah.
and I'm glad I grew up there. No, I mean, it sounds like crazy, but it was beautiful beach.
But Jews can't go to the beach because they burst into flames.
yes, I did, and luckily I ran into the water before I completely disintegrated.
Sure, of course. Yeah. Cool.
I know.
So, is there something?
There's a little bit of a little left, but you know, they can't get it all.
What is something in your life that you're looking forward to that's coming up? Just to finally to end.
Yeah,
no, we've had a great time.
This is great. What I'm looking forward to your show.
Okay.
And
after
your
that.
After that.
You may not think that afterwards.
what am I looking forward to?
Just anything you have coming up. Doesn't have to be a big deal. Just something you're looking forward to.
For the bike tour, because I'm going to raise money for the leukemia.
Are you also doing a
butt
tour?
You can say it from the butt at first.
Well, these guys are cute. I can't help it. But
the bike.
Yeah, I'm gonna raise money for the Leukemia Lymphoma Society,
okay.
And then May 1st, I'm going up to Albany with the Leukemia Lymphoma Society to try to get bills passed for like an oral chemotherapy bill passed that it would be considered a prescription. I'm considered a procedure, not a prescription.
Tell me the difference here. Well, you want oral chemotherapy to be easier to get, or
yes, easier. And
why?
For insurance, insurance companies won't cover it. If they look at it as a prescription, not a treatment, and it's thousands. You know, like it's a lot of money for.
Oh, so your medical insurance won't cover it because it's got to be part of your prescription plan, and then for most people, their prescription plan won't cover oral chemotherapy.
Exactly.
So you want New York State to pass a law that says that's
and it's things like that. Like that's where we're going up there and trying to get more funding for cancer research because I'm a big advocate of that.
You should show them your legs.
I hope that'll work. I have to find the single congressman up there.
Yeah, I was going to say the buff tour might bring in more.
The more the bike.
Somebody said, "Hey, when you donate to my bike tour," I'd be like, "I don't bike, I don't do it." But if somebody said, "Donate to my buck tour," I'd be like, "At least here's $5."
At least what?
Say, good luck to you.
$5.
Yeah, no. I was gonna give you $10. But
at least ask what it is. I would be more interested. It's just my opinion. I'll do my own buck tour.
You guys are awesome, and I thank you guys for listening to my show.
Thank you. Yeah, thanks for coming. Thanks for coming. Thank you. You did great. All right.
Yep. I mean, also stage.
Oh no!
Oh my God!
Perfect. All right. Now we're going to get myself based on there.
Mom, where's Dad?
What do you mean?
Dad!
He's right here.
It's okay. It's okay, son.
I can help you.
Dad, no! No! You can't help anyone!
No,
you see what you did?
No, I can help you.
That's why I always go to Dad first.
I can help you, truly.
Shut up, Mom!
No, please. I'm just as capable as your dad, if not more. He's having a heart attack.
Dad, are you okay?
I can help you.
I'll tough it out for you, son. Thank you. See?
You wouldn't have done that.
What's wrong? How was school?
Shut up.
Why?
Boy, sometimes can only talk to his father about a problem.
Come on.
What is it, Charlie?
School was
That's great. That's why are you seem so upset, though?
Because I thought I broke my finger, but I didn't.
Well, if you broke your finger, let me just
show you. Mom! You can't help me!
Just raise your hand.
No, I'm in pain. I was keeping it elevated.
Rice, rest, Rice.
Mom, where's Dad?
Why can't I...
Dad, where's Mom?
Oh, no.
Where's
oh,
Mom?
No. You have memento disease.
Mom!
Dad, you got a tattoo on your arm.
Not again.
Oh, Mom is right there.
Oh, I hate you.
No.
Whose car that is Danny's driving, but I'm worried about it.
It's the Ghostbusters car.
Okay, look. Two things. Your finger seems fine, and you can't treat your mother right. You're moving it way more than most people move their fingers.
You know, it hurts. It's not connected to any of my other fingers. Mom, Jesus fucking Christ.
Hey, Mike?
Yeah.
That new subway car you designed for the IRT lines?
Yeah.
Does it fit on the tracks?
Yeah, for sure. I'd like test it on the mile.
Did you measure it?
Yeah, measure it like once. Yeah. Measure once, put it in twice.
Yeah. I don't want to be an asshole, but we just rolled it on some of the actual tracks, not the model tracks. Doesn't look like it fits.
Come on, man.
Looks like it's way too narrow for the tracks. I mean, the wheels fit on the tracks themselves, but only one person can stand in there at a time. It's like 6 feet wide. It leaves like eight feet of clearance on either side of the subway car itself.
That's not my fault no one can jump that, right? Someone's got to know to jump that.
That's it. Murray, come on, I don't want to be a prick here, but you should take up the whole track, you know? People shouldn't be jumping from the platform on the subway.
Makes it more exciting, don't you think?
Huh?
Makes it more exciting.
Yeah, people don't want exciting, you know? They want to just...
Love it.
Oh, Jesus. I don't know if I can make that.
Excuse me! You gotta let people off first. Were you a tourist?
Yes. I'm not from around here. You look friendly.
It's obvious.
We look exactly alike.
No, oh. It's close.
This is the narrowest subway I've ever been in.
That's just because you're from out of town.
No.
Excuse me, I'm collecting change from a basketball team. Excuse me, I'm collecting change from a basketball team.
You smell like mashed potatoes. Oh, you have mashed potatoes all over you.
Okay.
Oh, no. Oh, no.
Excuse me, my Kindle.
I don't know what that is.
Thank you very much.
You're a very good breakdancer.
So you see, it's 86th. Stand clear of the closing doors.
Excuse me, this is my stop.
This is your stop?
Yeah, this is where I live.
Okay.
Right now.
Good luck. Oh. Have you seen any interesting sights since you've been in New York?
I saw that magical hobo that just went by.
I'm just visiting this town for the summer, and I'm looking to borrow some groceries.
Say, it's a grocery store. We don't lend out the groceries.
Okay, I just want to borrow some milk and cereal, and you know the basics. So I'm just going to have it for a month, and then I'll bring it back.
We don't do that. Really, the only use for groceries is to consume them.
No.
Yeah,
come
it is.
Come on! I'm having a little summer getaway. I want to get some flowers borrowed, and I'll bring it back in 30 days.
I don't understand what you'd be using it for if you're borrowing it.
Just to have groceries, and then I'll bring them back, let me borrow them. What's the difference to you?
The difference is that I'd be giving you things that we don't
need to sell. Come on!
I'm not dark.
I've never met a New Yorker before.
No, I haven't.
Okay.
I haven't heard that's not a stereotype.
Yeah, it is. It's a stereotype. The New Yorkers are kind of like have a bounce in their step, have some whimsy.
I've never heard that.
Okay, well, like you said, can I borrow some water?
I'll give you some water.
Okay, I'll
you
give
want
you
water?
Water.
A jug?
I'll bring it back to you.
The jug?
Yeah, I'm a big, like, Hinkley, you know.
You know, if giving you water is gonna...
Hey, are you the manager of the shop, right?
I am.
Yeah, I'd like to sell you some milk.
We don't buy milk.
You don't buy milk?
Well, we have a wholesaler, but we don't buy milk from guys in sweatsuits.
I got all this milk. I can give you rock bottom prices.
I don't want your milk. You've got it in a kid's wagon, and you're wheeling it into the store. I don't know where you got it from. I don't want to buy your milk.
I got it.
Buy my tuxedo, and you can tell I mean business. Hi, would you like to buy some milk? You look confused. Well, you must not have looked at my tuxedo yet.
You seem like a real classy guy.
Well, I'm a real classy guy.
We actually have a dairy farm that we buy our milk from.
Oh, you do?
Yes.
Could I get the address of that dairy farm?
Sure.
Hi. Good morning.
Good morning.
I thought you were churning butter, now I realize you're
I thought you were smoking a huge cow.
I did not know farmers had that stereotype.
There's a lot of things you don't know about us farmers. We're cheap, we don't tip well, and all classic farmer stereotypes. We run all the media. So what can I help you, sir? It's 4 a.m. at my farm.
As you can see, I'm in a tuxedo.
I noticed that.
I have two things. I would like to sell you some milk, and I would also like to see your horns.
The milk looks good.
It's pretty good milk.
But we have cows.
You do?
Yeah, so we don't need milk. We actually sell milk.
Oh, because milk. Oh, I didn't even think of that.
Hey! You rented this tuxedo. We need it back. It was a rented tuxedo.
Oh, I'm sorry. I thought when you said rented, you meant just keep the tuxedo.
No, man. We're the type of business that actually does let you have things temporarily. Oh.
Shoot. Got a bunch of cummerbunds here if you need any.
Oh, we gonna ring that bell?
Valerie!
Yeah.
Valerie! There's a car crash outside. We need your leg to help the people.
Oh, no, sir. Yes.
Yes.
Oh, my God. I hope everything's all right.
Is she okay?
Help me.
You gotta get the car off. We need your leg. We need your leg to get the car off.
Valerie. Please.
She's doing her warm-ups.
That woman can't help me from the waist up. She needs work.
No, it's not the waist up. It's gonna help you.
After I do that, you have to understand how many people can.
You saved my life.
You're welcome.
We gotta get back to our improv class.
Yeah. Good luck to you.
Thank
you. Joyce.
Joyce?
Yeah, I do
everyone's
a lot of
been shouting Valerie. Everyone's been shouting Valerie about you the whole
time? Oh, my superhero name is Joyce. I see who I am.
What the fuck is this horse shit, Gary?
Nothing, Michael.
Gary, I submitted an advertisement for my goddamn and I'm seeing him.
Good, good, good. Good, Michael. Okay. Over here.
Good, 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 good.
Not on the couch. So what's the matter, Michael?
I submitted a copy about my prescription and acid.
Yeah, the one that raises T-cell counts
yes.
in HIV patients?
Yes.
I can't let you print that. It's antacid. It's like $5.99 on a prescription. You can't just tell people it cures
Why
HIV.
Not? Why can't I do that?
Because, I mean, besides the morality that comes into mind here, there's like legal issues and...
Oh, bullshit.
You have a picture of Magic Johnson lifting up a car and says, guess
because he doesn't have heartburn. His heartburn is gone.
But it's inferring something else.
His heartburn's gone, so he feels strong enough to lift a car. That's all
I'm saying. It's inferring something else. It's a zoomed-in shot of his blood. Now that, it makes no sense.
It does.
I feel like, look,
it doesn't.
I don't know how it got this far along. I don't know what kind of client you're working for, what kind of scumbags you're pushing.
It's just GasX.
GasX is pushing some deep messages. Well, Michael, if there's something else going on, you gotta tell me, man.
Scratch the back of my head.
You're gonna get a bath tonight.
Really?
Wash you in the sink like we usually do?
People don't just want to not have gas and not have heartburn. They want to dream. They want to dream big. So I want people who have HIV or AIDS who also have heartburn to think, I'm going to cure my heartburn and my gas. But maybe my AIDS will go away too.
Hey, it would be great if everyone thought that, but I don't know if we can legally make that true about your product.
You're a stick in the mud.
That makes me a stick in the mud? Should we talk about any of your other ads?
Sure, let's. I stand by everything I've ever submitted.
Oh, this ad of Christopher Reeves crossing a marathon finish line?
Yes.
Albeit it's dated, but let's be honest.
Because he got a tan.
Yeah, I know. It just shows him sunglass tan line and says, use our prescription tanning booths? I don't even know. There's like five levels of things wrong with this ad.
We have prescription tanning booths that would make even someone who's paralyzed from the neck down feel like they should run a marathon because they look so good.
This ad infers so much more than that. It infers that people need to tan for prescription purposes in the first place.
Sure.
What kind of health plan covers prescription tanning?
Not enough. I'm petitioning the legislature. Cover my prescription tanning books.
Thank you. You want to talk about this other end?
Yes.
All right. This one right here has Webster at 6'8", 280 pounds. This one you did even longer ago than the first one.
Yeah.
And I let that one slide.
Yeah.
And
the toenail fungus free.
I know.
And when your toenails are fungus free, you feel twice as tall.
See?
You do.
That's not even a metaphor. You don't feel twice as tall.
Have you had toenail fungus?
Yes, and I did not feel 3 foot
You're
seven.
You're a liar.
I'm a liar?
You felt half as tall when you had that toenail fungus under your toenails. As soon as you got rid of it, you felt like a tall guy again. That's how it works. Why are you crawling up my ass, Gary? Why are you crawling up my ass about all my ads?
Are you fucking kidding me?
What?
Get in your crate.
I don't want to go.
Get in your crate. Okay, fine. You don't want to get in your crate. But I know you like Slim Jims.
If I go on the crate to get that Slim Jim, are you going to close the crate door?
You guys, this is serious. The building's on fire. The hallway's blocked. We can't get out.
Oh.
You don't see him.
That is? He's right. That's serious.
You guys, this might be our last day on Earth, but I just want to plug a couple things. Okay. First of all, Mary's already dead. She died in the fire. She's the one who set the fire.
That's not a plug.
What?
That's not a plug.
I know, but I was just getting the rest of the information out.
Okay.
Mary set the fire and then immediately died.
She immediately died. She set herself on fire.
Why
and ran
did
she
do
into
it?
Wait, so we don't have to go to Mary's Tupperware party next
week. No, that's the good news. We don't have to go to Mary's next week. And we also won't be alive.
Okay, right.
But just in case we do make it out, me and my friends are doing a little set at McNuttleberry's. It's a one-man show type thing. It's getting hard to breathe in here.
You and your friends are doing a one-man show?
Me and my friends are
doing a one-man show. Like, did you create a character and you
rotated it out? Or you sit on each other's shoulders in a trench coat like the Muppets?
Yeah.
What's the content?
The content?
That's a real normal question people ask.
Yeah.
What is the content?
I was asking the content, and I tell them everything they're going to see in the show.
That's a normal phrasing of a question.
What's the content of the show? It's complete.
It's called One Man Show. It's called One Man on Stage. There's seven of us on stage. Only one of us speaks. Don't roll
me. You're not on fire yet.
And you're just stirring up the smoke to go lower.
God. Bobby died in that fire last week.
Do you think we can still go on with the one-man show? Guys, we already sold out McNuttleberries.
We wrote this content. We should perform it.
All right, yeah, we're going to start it right now.
Hey, no, you get...
I want to get off this one.
Yeah, I need to go up top.
Yes, that's
how we rehearsed it.
it, okay?
But without Bobby here, he was the strongest.
Well, Bobby was at the bottom.
He had those tree trunk legs.
Yeah.
But from the waist up, he was a piece of human
body. Hey, his words.
He said it.
He did say it.
Guys, you know the old adage. Don't leave a McNuttleberry's audience waiting.
Oh my God!
You guys!
Oh, no, wait, keep going.
No. Bobby!
It's not me, it's not Bobby, it's his twin brother, Robbie!
Robbie!
Robbie! It's me!
Well, Robbie, you're the perfect size to be on the bottom of the experiment.
Oh, your legs are too tiny!
No, Robbie!
But from the waist up, you're
perfect! I'm sorry?
But from the waist up, you're absolutely perfect.
Yeah. Our family was kind of like the movie Twins.
Except instead of an Arnold and a Danny DeVito, it's half Arnold, half, half DeVito Danny in DeVito. Both parties.
A Schwartz and DeVito.
That's what everyone
Bobby
at school
and Robbie calls. Schwartz and DeVito.
That's what everyone at school called us, those bastards.
Well, do you know the lines?
Of course I know all the lines.
The
I wrote the damn thing.
Guys. McDonaldberries is on fire.
What?
Old McDonaldberries.
Okay. Quickly, you know.
The audience, we kept them waiting, so they started burning the theater down.
Roll!
Well, you really want me to roll?
You're on fire.
You're on fire. You always stop that roll when you're on fire. Well, let's go through the normal questions that we ask when there's been a fire in an audience. What's the content? I loved your resume. I just want to say it was great. It was a great resume. Excuse
Thank
me,
you so
stupid
much.
Beeper.
Beeper?
Yeah, I still have a beeper. I'm crazy like that. Look, I just look. If you want to work here, you need two attributes.
Okay.
One, you need to be highly intelligent. I can see that from your resume. And two, good. You stay calm in crazy situations. It's exactly what we're looking for as an editor of our magazine, Highlights for Children. Those are two requirements. Some intelligence and the ability to handle fucking crazy situations. Okay.
Alright, okay, you guys, so for Goofus and Gowan, we just kind of want to pitch, like, Goofus doing something, you know, like Gowan he's not supposed to be doing, then Gowan kind of being, like, and, you know, telling him what to do, so...
That's great. No, that's great. People are gonna love that.
Is this the Goofus and Gowan pitch meeting?
That's right.
Okay, cool. And you are Karen, the new girl?
Yes.
We just want to let you know that we have your kids hostage, and some Al-Qaeda members are thinking of slitting their throats.
Well, I better write a Goofus and Gowan panel so you can tell them to wait.
You just passed your first review. What was that?
You thought I cared about my kids?
You heard her. Kill him.
Okay, so who has an idea for what Goofus can be doing?
Maybe he can be building a birdhouse.
Okay.
Out of children's bones.
We're just about to take this to press, you know, and everything looks pretty okay, except for the Goofus and Gallant. It's taking a dark turn this month. We have Gallant here, builds a birdhouse to feed birds. Goofus uses children's bones to make the same birdhouse. That's not silly. That's terrifying. No, I know. There's a bird eating cornmeal out of a children's skull in this picture. Who drew that? One dark mofo. I hope. I'm trying to work that into more conversations.
We're just gonna.
I just want to make sure that that's exactly what we're going to print with.
Exactly. We're trying to up kids' maturity, so we're trying to introduce slowly more things in the highlights that are going to.
And then here in the back.
Yeah.
Tony, where have you been? I've been beeping you all day.
Are you stop doing beepers? I'm vibrating. Can't feel it because my
guys, great news.
What is it?
Kids all over the world are eating cornmeal out of other children's skulls.
We did it!
Before it even went to print.
No!
I at a Jewish person before.
Excuse me?
I said, you look Jewish, and I ain't never met no Jewish person before.
Hey, how you doing, Josh? Nice to meet
you. Hi. My name's Cooter.
I like your bindle.
Oh, yeah, I stole it. Right, can I ask you questions about your ancient religion?
Of course, sure.
What's a satyr?
You know, I don't know. I think what it is, look, I gotta tell you something. I was born Jewish, but I don't practice it.
Oh, okay.
But I can tell you the things that I tell my friends about it.
Sure.
Come sit down.
Okay.
How'd you find me out here?
I'm just walking around looking for a rabbit I lost.
I've been Jewish all my life, but recently I'm not as religious as I used to be.
Mm-hmm.
So it makes me feel kind of embarrassed. I just don't want to be, the spokesperson for my entire religion.
Did someone say spokesperson for the Jewish religion?
I did it.
Yeah, I did.
Hi. Seth Goldstein?
Great.
Can I help you guys?
Please.
I'm just curious about your culture and heritage. Well, then we're in for a wild ride tonight, guys.
What's your name, son?
Cooter.
Nice Jewish name.
I hate Jewish.
You hate Jewish?
I hate Jewish.
You hate Jewish.
You hate a Jewish person?
I hate Jewish. Now you're making fun of me.
No, I just didn't understand. I'm sorry.
I hate Jewish.
You only have one tooth and it's real tiny.
And it falls out a lot.
Oh, no.
I keep shoving it back into the socket of my tongue. Tooth socket.
Into your tooth socket.
That's adorable.
Dude, you's gone all day.
Yeah.
Before we rice and jello, why don't you go ahead and light this?
Well, I got bad news and I got good news. Bad news is, no, I didn't catch that rabbit. Good news, I met two Jewish folk in the woods learned all about the religion.
Oh,
turns
yeah.
out, full moon don't do nothing to them. And the cedar is the path of a meal where family gets together and reads the story of the Exodus.
Well, we did learn one thing.
What's that?
That they all live in the woods.
Oh, good.
How about what I heard that back thing about Yom Kippur?
Yeah, who's this man, Yom Kippur?
It's another holiday.
Yeah?
Yeah, they got a bunch.
They sure do celebrate a holiday.
They got high holidays and, less high holidays.
I'm sorry, did you guys happen to see a purebred French bulldog run by here?
Yeah.
Oh my God, you're Hicks.
Yeah, we're kind of Hicks.
Oh, can I? I'm sorry, I've never met an actual Hick. I just know all these stereotypes because I live in the city.
Oh, sure.
Can I ask you guys?
That's a stool made of stool.
I noticed that. It's calcified animal feces, I hope?
Yep, we're the animals.
Wow. Real Hicks.
What do you want?
Woof!
Woof!
Pookie, wait in the car. I forgot to mention that my dog was an animated cartoon. Look, I have so many questions for the Hicks.
Go ahead and shoot.
Go ahead and
shoot. Go ahead, shoot.
Not a real gun, though. Just your mouth.
Wait, first, my mouth is feeling uncomfortable. What do you say we switch teeth?
Oh, yeah.
We don't prefer to be called
to
Hicks.
To the left. Pass it to the left.
Pass it to the
left. Tooth to the left.
Tooth to the left.
Our preferred terminology for ourselves is mountain idiots.
Mountain idiots. Okay. Alright. Because all my friends are like, don't go down there, you're gonna get hicked up or hicked down or something like that. But I had some questions. So, do you guys find like close familial relatives attractive?
What's a relative?
What's a relative? I'll just blow right on to the next question.
I gave birth to her, she gave birth to him, and he and I sleep in the same cove.
So you
a cove
is a water inlet.
Cove wasn't the thing I had a question about.
I see.
Oh, yeah. So stereotypes are true. The cove.
Now we can go down to the cove.
No, nope, I'm talking more about sleeping with your own grandma.
Oh, only if you're horny.
Oh, okay. And then.
Ever since the rabbit got away, what else is there supposed to do?
Now, I feel like I'm a little messed up because I'm thinking you guys take turns banging that rabbit.
Kiss it three times.
We kiss that rabbit too.
A rabbit's mouth is three times the size of
a mouse's mouth.
This is all stuff I do already know.
And it's just a truth about the cove.
Yeah,
it's not a mountain jet, but there's an inlet water.
I know what a cove is.
You know how big a mouse's mouth is? Three times smaller than a rabbit's.
I follow.
Hey, Jamie.
Hi, how's it going today?
Good. I can't find my stapler. Did you take my fucking stapler?
I borrowed it. It's right here.
You borrowed it? You have been here for 6 days! What the shit is wrong with you? You don't just take someone's stapler off their desk! Ah! God!
Here.
Is everything all right?
No, everything's not all right, Charles.
Idiot took my stapler off my desk without even asking. She's only been here for 6 years. Now, the first time I took a stapler off someone's desk, I was here for 14 years before I pulled that kind of rookie bullshit.
You took the stapler off his desk?
I borrowed Frank's stapler because I haven't gotten one yet.
Can we get everyone in the office out here and see how dumb you are? Can we do that? Thank you, Charles. She's dumb as shit! She steals, and she's bad!
I borrowed, and I've just returned it.
You're the black hole of staplers!
You might as well burn yourself.
Yes.
Now,
Mary knows about burning. She invites us all to her Tupperware party every week. We love going, don't we?
Yeah!
I'm confused what we're mad about now! Mad at her because she took my stapler without asking! She's only been here for 6 days!
What in the D word?
A dick, huh? A dildo?
Whoa!
Whoa!
I worked here for 16 years before I said shit once when I stubbed my toe. Can't just come out swearing? What do you think you are, the CFO?
There's rules! Wait, are you the CFO?
Oh no!
Undercover boss!
Yep, that's right. I've been undercover for 6 days and it was real hard.
We should expect this more often because
I have to give that back to Janine. Okay, this is actually belongs to a woman named Janine. It's her actual skin.
Wait, so you're telling me somewhere there's a woman that's just muscle, bone, and organs? Sorry, boys, I'm out of here.
That's right, I've been undercover.
Oh, for 6 days?
6 days, that's right. Thursday, Friday, up until now, Thursday. No, it doesn't count. I was back home to my husband and my children and my pool.
So technically, it's a week and 2 days.
Why would I have been here 6 days?
Okay, so it was a 2-day
break.
Well,
no, 3 days.
Listen,
I'm not. Are you bringing the suit?
I mean, I was having fun with it.
So, on the days you weren't here, you were wearing the skin suit for
sometimes? Yeah.
Honey, the kids are asleep.
Oh, let me put on my Janine suit.
Yeah. I'm gonna put on my you suit. I don't mean a baby lamb.
I know, it's me.
It's you.
I'm feeling your lesbian fantasy right now.
I've always wanted to be my own wife. I think I would want her co-workers. By the way, that's the D word.
Oh, I'll try and remember that if that ever comes up.
Okay, because you always forget what the D word is.
So when I was 8 years old, I walked in on my parents. It's okay that my friend Roy is here for my therapy session.
Absolutely. I
pretend I'm not here.
Absolutely.
Caught my parents asleep, having sex.
Oh, fuck.
Yeah, right?
He's told me this like a million times, dude. It's the worst.
Yeah.
He walks in, right?
Uh-huh.
And then
but like, dad,
I got a piece of his dad. His dad's dressed up like his mom. Uh-huh.
And
then shut up, man. And then, oh, dude, it's fucked. Let him tell you.
Let him tell
you. How do I feel about it?
Scary.
I don't give a shit.
Because we're thinking about it at the time.
Man, I'm good, man. I'm fucking Roy, man. I'm tight as shit. No problems.
Okay, we're all here because we walked in on our mom dressed as a coworker while our dad was dressed as the mom's original skin. And they were engaging in lesbian sex. That's what we all have in common. We've scoured the world for 25 years and found all four of you. So, I feel like, first of all, no one's tried my brownies, and I... You know what? That's not important. Getting sidetracked. Let's discuss. How's everyone feeling?
I'm just happy to be amongst people who understand for the first time.
Yeah, I've been trying to find creative ways to deal with them. Trying to get a one-man show up, and I don't know if it's gonna work. But
well, why don't you have us be in it with you?
Wait. Yeah. Yes. Yes!
Your dad was Manu Bull, right? So we'll have to get on top of each other's shoulders and be tall.
No, her mom's co-worker was Manu Bull.
Oh.
Her mom was also the Denver Nuggets.
Oh.
It's hard to follow. So
yeah.
Her dad dressed up as her mom was a Denver Nuggets player. The first female player to play in the NBA, alongside Manu Bull on the Denver Nuggets.
Well, I thought that was clear.
Yeah. That's the content of the show.
That makes sense. Thank you.
How are they?
I don't know yet, I haven't.
How are they?
How are they?
How are they?
They're pretty good.
Yeah. Are they so good that they'll make you forget that you're dad once dressed up as your mom and fucked her while she was dressed as herself?
Whoa! Dressed as herself?
That's fucking weird.
That's weird.
Man. You are.
What?
Wait.
Mom, weird.
I thought we were all in the same boat here.
No,
our mom was dressed as her co-worker.
I'm always alone! I'm always alone!
Joyce, we need you!
I'm sorry.
Joyce, we need you!
What's wrong?
Somebody's trapped underneath 14 subways.
Oh no!
We need your
alerts.
Our
one-man show.
No! Please! Help us!
Oh my God! There's three of you like a totem pole. Make everybody's collapse.
I don't know. I just walked upon them.
Oh,
that
no.
Poor woman in the middle.
You're a human centipede.
Use your legs, Joyce.
Of course.
Okay.
Help us!
I'm trying. I'm just trying to figure out the best way to do it first.
I knew we should have tried to get out when it was only 13 subways. Why'd we say, throw one more arm? One more
arm. One more arm!
Oh, he's dead! Oh, no!
No! Oh, no!
Yeah!
Running.
Yeah.
And you're late for work.
Yeah.
This is the third time you've been late on that.
Look, this is going to sound crazy.
Oh, I've heard it all. I've heard it all.
I went to a meeting of people whose fathers dress up like their mothers and have lesbian sexual activities with their wives. And once I figured out that I was the only one there that had truly happened to, I ran around, and then I saved
You want to catch your breath?
People. I'm sorry?
You need to catch your breath?
No, I'm telling you what just happened. That's proof.
All right.
And I'm slightly overweight.
I think you look great.
Thanks. Wow. Hey.
Hey, I got a skin suit in my office. You wouldn't mind wearing it.
Waiting for someone to ask me that my entire life. It's probably gonna be a little fucked up though, because it's what made me a crazy person.
Thanks for bringing work to me.
Assignments,
we're
pulling the plug now.
I need about 20 minutes to finish up some memos.
Yeah.
Really, we're supposed to euthanize you right now.
Okay, but we're just kind of going over spring budget stuff, and really, you're the only one that had an inside view.
Just give me let me help you with this, and then just like give me like 2 minutes to say goodbye to my family and friends.
I know, I heard you were sick, and I was like, I know she's going to want some soup and to finish those budgets, because if you didn't finish them, we'd kind of be screwed.
I said soup and sushi, but just the miso soup is fine. Wanted one last sushi roll.
Okay, yeah.
It's all right, don't worry about it.
All right, are you sure? Because
You're swamped.
I am swamped. It's just like a really busy time.
Is this really happening? I'm supposed to euthanize this woman. She has a rapidly spreading body parasite.
I tried everything. Tannin and acid. Nothing worked. Yeah. So I just resigned that I'm gonna die.
I'm so sorry. Okay, will it increase if we move this budget?
You gotta amortize them.
Fact checking.
Yes. How would you like a job in editing?
Punk.
Excuse me. Hi, I'm Raising Bunny. I'm doing a 5-borough butt tour.
Oh. Interesting.
Yeah, so I'm raising money.
Hold on, let me get my checkbook.
Oh, great. Oh, wow, it's very impressive.
And I opted for the huge checkbook.
So you can, butt tour, yeah.
Out to again?
You can make it out to me.
Just me?
No, like my name. My name. Oh, you're after my void.
Oh, shoot. Hold on, let me put this in my paper shredder.
Okay. Big paper shredder.
This should just be about 45 minutes.
Is that my twin brother, Robbie, using my school supplies? Yes. It's me, Manute Bull.
Who's your brother?
More like that movie Twins, but in reverse, and then flipped it like this.
Well, I'm raising money for a butt tour if you want to donate also.
How are you, Manute?
I'm good. What'd you say?
Welcome to Manhattan's third annual butt tour!
Come here from Kenya to scoop my butt out.
Thank you guys, that's our show.
Once again, this is Sheridan O'Neill. I'm Bob Moynihan, Frank Gillespie, Neil Casey, John Gabris. You can go to the UCB website, or I haven't done this in a while.
Go to UCBtheater.com. We have shows at our two venues in New York City, 7 nights a week, as well as in Los Angeles. And thanks, you guys.
Thank you.